Only one obstacle now lay between the heroes and the bastion of hope. Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya would have to cross the forlorn marshlands surrounding the Nightly Keep.
Pontius, do we really have to cross this miserable marsh to get to the bastion?
That's the way it is. Or we could take the road. But I'm not sure where exactly that is. Or where we are.
We won't want to dip our toes in that puddle.
Lady Sunny, that cursed monster! There's no court of justice good enough for those miserable, treasonous fiends and their vile devilries. Treason, kidnapping, murder, mutilation, destruction of the kingdom, framing us as villains. Is there nothing those crooks wouldn't stoop to?
I have a funny feeling we're going to experience more of all of that firsthand. But I'm sure we'll be fine.
Thank you.
The fog's so thick I can barely see anything. So, the Clockwork Knights came through here. They stole Valerius' magic powers and used them to turn knights into stone.
How do we save that poor wizard?
First, we find whichever tin can Valerius' magic is trapped in and proceed from there.
Thank you.
this path leads to an old knightly shrine.
Little did Pontius know what would happen when he stepped upon the torchlit path. He would have to trek through the eerie marshlands to get to the shrine dedicated to the founders of his knightly order.
It's been a miserable adventure so far. Children kidnapped, the kingdom ground to dust. I wonder what these dead old knights would think about that. Who's there?
Remember, even the smallest light in the dark can make a difference.
It's rare that ghosts are on our side. Usually we and the undead are not on good terms. Thank you.
Time to move on.
Also, I have a new magical thingy-bob on my shield.
Lovely.
Visited the Red Rose for the 50th time to check on the non-existent ghosts supposedly in their attic, which seems to conveniently elude wizards all the time. At least they offered me a wonderful dinner for my trouble, which is unfortunate, as I won't have room for cake tomorrow at the garden party for the heroes of Trine, Wilhelmina.
Poor Master Wizardess.
Did they, Fancy Pants?
Wait, what? How did you do that? Is the stone spell reversible?
You think I'd live with a wizard who turns other people to stone and not take any precautions? I made myself an amulet of protection. Too bad it has a slow reaction time. Well, isn't that always the case with prototypes?
Any chance you have three of those to spare? We're going to try and save your friend, but that's not going to happen if we end up as garden gnomes.
A tall order, but I'll see what I can do. Meet me at the edge of the marsh before you storm the bastion.
Oh, she turned into a bird.
Yes, Helga does that.
Useful trick.
Well, it's certainly no box or a plank.
Thank you.
Lucius's satchel. It's so heavy with books. Maybe Pontius could use it as a weapon.
This beats swimming in the mud.
Also, I think we're nearly there.
Ah, good news for a change.
Here are the amulets I promised. They only provide limited protection against being turned to stone. You might experience slight discomfort, but once the magic kicks in, you'll be fine. Good luck, heroes of Trine.
Thank you ever so much, Helga.
You can thank me best by saving Valerius.
Pontius had been looking forward to returning to the Bastion of Hope after a long time away from the knightly stronghold, although the circumstances might have been happier. It was time for the heroes to see if they could save the knights and the wizard Valerius from the most terrifying of fates. The knights from being all turned into stone, and Valerius from being enslaved by the Clockwork Army.
Oh, I remember the first time we sailed here. I was only a little boy swabbing decks on my father's ship.
A ship? Pontius, you never told us of these adventures.
Well, the thing was, I would always get seasick out in the open water. So, my sister got the ship and I got to keep my land legs.
Thank you.
Bastion of Hope will never surrender. Not as long as I'm here. Hello, little brother. There's a spot of trouble in the kingdom, although I guess you've caught wind of it already. Wouldn't have taken you for one to blow up a castle or to get locked up in dungeons. Whatever is going on there, good luck with it.
Oh, a letter from my sister. That's nice. She usually never writes.
Thank you.
is where I first met my fellow knights.
What a shame, it's in ruins now.
The stuck-up brutes made an everlasting impression on the frontiers.
Enough reminiscing. Come on, it's time we leave our own marks on those treacherous tin men.
Immense. It just keeps on going.
You get a good workout just running from one place to another here.
Well, how are we to know which one of the clockwork monsters has stolen Valerius's magic powers?
Let's look for more petrified knights. Eventually, we should find the source.
Won't you sit with me, raise a toast with me, and tell me where you've been? Grab a bite with me, share your day with me. We've missed you at the Red Rose Inn.
The Red Rose Inn drinking song. Haven't heard that one in a long time.
Thank you. to dismantle every rock in the Bastion of Hope and transport them back to the capital.
Over my dead body!
Is an interesting little workshop.
The new airship hangar. Not sure airboats are any better than sea boats.
It would certainly be faster to fly instead of walking.
Here's where we had a great big celebration after I became a knight.
I'm guessing the place was in better shape at the time.
Those clockwork knights don't really seem to care for architecture or public safety.
Thank you.
knightly headpiece.
Petrified knights.
Hate to say this, but poor fellows.
Magics are inside the lizard.
Thank you.
This is extraordinary.
And disconcerting.
I think this belongs to Valerius. But what if it's not his? What if it's, I don't know, Wilhelmina's? Will we end up with Wilhelmina in Valerius's body?
Your fancy pants is right. We should study this first.
Yes, I propose a hands-on experiment.
What happened to all the metallic monsters? Amadeus, when did you get here?
Looks like we delivered our part of the deal. Now we need your help in taking down Sunny and Godric.
And finding my children.
And restoring the knighthood!
Let's see what we can do.
With her powers of clairvoyance, the seeress, Barbara, had found the location of the villain's magnificent airship. The wizards of the observatory even let our heroes borrow their air cycle to get up to the clouds. But what sort of adversity would the heroes now meet, facing Lady Sunny, Lord Godric, and their clockwork minions, all the while soaring through the skies?